Everyone's got a cell phone, compact fluorescent lights are the norm, and we cook our dinners in the microwave every night. Or at least I do. Could all these electromagnetic waves whipping around be harmful? Hi everyone, Julian here for DNews. A recent article by Ed Cumming in The Guardian describes a tiny hamlet in West Virginia with an array of massive radio telescopes looming over it. Telescopes like this are extremely sensitive. This year, in Australia, what was originally thought to be a major breakthrough in the search for life was actually just bursts of radiation emitted when someone was opening the microwave in the break room before the timer went off. So, in order to pick up radio waves from the edges of the universe clearly, the town has to be an electromagnetic dead zone. This means no cell signals or radio, and if you have Wi-Fi in your home, occasionally, some nice men and women from the telescope will come around and ask you to turn it off. While this sounds like my own personal version of hell to others, it's a safe haven. Not from the barrage of Facebook and Twitter, which I totally get, and by the way, you can follow me at jhug00, but from the electromagnetic waves themselves. Diane Shu is one of these people seeking peace in Green Bank because she claims she's electrosensitive. Shu says she moved there after she started getting severe headaches, blurred vision, and skin rashes. She described her symptoms as radiation sickness and attributed it to a US cellular tower by her home, but she's also sensitive to fluorescent lights and electric fences. She's not alone either, and since she moved to Green Bank, 40 other electrosensitive people have joined her. But is it real? Can the invisible little waves that constantly surround us have an effect on our bodies? Science says, probs not. First, consider Shu's own account. She says she was sensitive only to US cellular towers, and specifically, she said she didn't react to AT&T. The problem with that is, US cellular uses frequencies around 850 megahertz and 1900 megahertz, and so does AT&T. So right away, her claim is looking suspect. She also likens her symptoms to radiation sickness, but there's a problem there too. Just because electromagnetic radiation has the word radiation in it, doesn't mean it's going to cause radiation sickness. Radio and microwaves have less energy than visible light, and substantially less energy than X-rays or gamma rays. These higher energy waves, along with particles emitted from nuclear radiation, can damage tissue and cause radiation sickness by stripping electrons off atoms. Microwaves? Not so much. Most people who report electromagnetic sensitivity also report a wide range of symptoms that vary greatly, so it makes their case harder to substantiate. There's also the fact that Shu says she's sensitive to fluorescent lights. Fluorescents do emit more UVB radiation than incandescents, but UV radiation is at a wavelength that are orders of magnitude smaller than radio or microwaves. They're on the other side of the spectrum as visible light, so why isn't visible light also irritating? Plus, the falloff of radiation from compact fluorescent lights, or CFLs, is so steep that at just 4 feet away, it's equivalent to background radiation. CFLs are different than incandescents because they flicker, and you might guess the flickering from fluorescent lights is giving Shu her headaches, but that's unlikely because modern fluorescent bulbs flicker at 10,000 to 40,000 cycles per second, and that is way too fast for the human eye to see. Studies have looked into the claims of electrosensitivity too, and they haven't turned up any concrete evidence it's a thing either. A double-blind study from 2006 observed 60 self-reported sensitive people as well as 60 non-sensitive control participants. They were exposed to a 900 megahertz pulsing signal, a non-pulsing signal, and a condition with no signal present. The sensitive subjects reported symptoms when a signal was present 60% of the time. They reported symptoms when a signal wasn't present 63% of the time. So it doesn't really seem like they can tell. That's not to say that the symptoms aren't real, but the cause is probably not electromagnetic frequencies. It's the belief that it's electromagnetic frequencies. It could be another case of the placebo effect's evil twin, the nocebo effect. So, despite the abundance of invisible waves carrying phone calls and dirty Snapchats past you in the air, it looks like you're going to be A-okay, so long as you think you're going to be A-okay. If you're not terrified of radiation, good news! You can also use it to wirelessly charge your phone. Yay, less wires and more radiation. Trace explains how it works here.
A battery uses a chemical reaction to produce a stream of electrons. It's a lot of work for not a lot of payoff. A capacitor, on the other hand, cuts out that chemical middleman completely and simply holds on to the electrons until you need them.
Okay, that's what the science says about electromagnetic sensitivity. Are there any other strange conditions caused by modern living that you want us to look into? Let us know in the comments or find us on Facebook or Twitter at DNews. And I'll see you next time.